He's got outstanding vocals. They are very smart musicians. They don't miss a note. Welcome back, and thank you for joining me for another reaction video. If you are new, please don't forget to subscribe, turn on notifications, and you'll get alerts when these go live. Today we're taking a look at the Devin Townsend Project and a song called Deadhead live at the Royal Albert Hall. It was a big request that came through on my first reaction to him, which was a song called Kingdom. It was a live studio recording. A lot of you guys were asking for this one. Now we get to see a live performance, or the capturing of a live performance. So I'm really excited to see how he plays with, I'm assuming, a full band, how he interacts with the audience, how the band members work together. Really love looking at live stuff now that I've got somewhat of a feel. I mean, I'm still scraping the barrel in terms of, I'm very new to his sound, but really keen to see what he's about. I know he is very technical, has such a great understanding of music. He's quite theatrical. He's got a lot of personality. So I'd love to see how that translates onto the big stage. Anyway, can't wait. Devin Townsend Project, Deadhead, live at the Royal Albert Hall. Let's see what you got. He knows exactly what tone he wants out of his guitar, and he's able to get it. And that's what a big problem that a lot of guitarists have, myself included, is we know what sound we want, but we can't get it through any mixture of pedals or amps. We get close, but we can't zone in on exactly. It seems like he knows exactly what he wants, and he's able to produce it wherever he wants, whenever he wants. It's a beautiful distorted tone, but it's definitely got enough clarity to hear all those notes shift. Now, he's doing a very simple palm muting piece. Palm muting is when you use your palm to muffle the sound of the strings, but you can let go and let certain notes shine through, if you will. And then he's doing a couple slides and some bends on the notes as well, but a beautiful, simple piece, but a lot of melody, great tone. And it sounds like there's a bit of like synth in the back. It sounds like there's a little bit of that. So let's see where they go with this. Ordinarily, when they pick through chords like that, it's because those chords are going to be strummed out later and played in a much bigger piece, but let's see. What I really like about this is it is just shuffling through like two simple chords back and forth, and he's doing a couple slides and moves on some of them. But what's interesting is as he's playing the chord, he's kind of opening up and closing, so he's getting that distinction, or at least intricacy within that just simple chord by opening and closing it, and creates this different melodic sound to it. The guitarists are just really powerfully hitting that simple guitar riff home. Drummer is phenomenal. The sound is great. When I say the drummer is phenomenal, you can hear by every note he hits, it's got the same consistency and same pressure. And they're obviously all professional musicians, so this might sound obvious, but I'm really impressed by that. And you've got the guy, I think he's playing keys, right? So he's doing a bit of synth work, which is this background filler. It almost creates this wall. It helps reinforce this wall of sound that you're hearing. And then you got the bassist whose notes are ringing out. Then he's not being as active as the guitarist on the upstrum, but it creates like a blanket that sits on top of the music. It's just a very, very full, very simple, but very smart melody. And I'm all for it. That's so cool, that stage. We'll be right back. He knows how to command an audience, huh? Going back, as you can hear, that synth starts to climb as they're about to go into this next piece. Go back a little bit more. It's very, very cool. I love how you can hear it because it's been playing a background role. It's kind of there, but it's not there. And then you can hear it start climbing up and pull back again. Very cool. I love when his vocal, he's got such a great voice. He's actually an incredible singer, but he also knows when to pull back. So there were a couple notes that started to be belted out there, started to be pushed out. There was a lot more air coming through, and then he pulled it back again. And again, live performances, love the kind of thing where the singers are being subtle, but because you have to get quite close to the mic, sometimes their lips touch and you get some of those imperfections, the live imperfections, which are all character and personality. It's very cool. He's not oversung the melody, and you can, there is a risk of that when you keep the guitar work simple, but he obviously knows exactly what he's doing. Imagine being there. Oh. I'm just going to stop it there because I'm getting goosebumps, man. This is crazy. His voice is so powerful. There, he's definitely letting more power through. His screams and his growls are great. The one thing I love about this, and this is probably a credit to the engineer as well, and engineers are actually an additional band member. You know, when you guys work together really well, he's as important to the song as the artists are. And, you know, having the power that Devin Townsend has in his just standard clean singing and his growls, to get that balance right, to make sure that when you're growling, when you're screaming, it isn't overpowering in terms of volume, at the mixers right, he's got this awesome, what I can only describe as the perfect amount of reverb on his voice, because when he really belts it out, you can hear it echo throughout the stadium. It feels like it's wrapping around the walls, but then when he goes back and he's more subtle, it's not overkill. Very, very cool. Such a simple song, but such a beautiful melody. You almost get lost in it. You're like swaying and you just want to close your eyes and drift away with it. It's awesome. Is that simp? Sorry, this is too funny for me. I always comment about how fans and crowds are notoriously terrible at keeping rhythm. The minute there's a crowd participation piece, whether it's a silent piece where there's an option to clap, whether it's a piece where they take over the singing, they just lose it completely. And it's so difficult. And it's just because there's so many people, right? And it's so difficult for the band to find their way back in. And that's why they'll have in-ears and they'll have click tracks and things like that. So I saw him look back at the drummer and I wonder if he was almost trying to signal him to, because sometimes the drummer will do some percussive stuff, like he'll just hit his kick to let the audience know what to follow. So I wonder if he was trying to look at him like, maybe we should help them out. I'm going to go back again because that was really funny, but His face says it all. He's such a character. Jamie's even trying to show them. Did he just say pick a tempo? Oh, this guy's got personality, man. Cross the bench for sure. You feel like it at any point, though, you know? Pick a tempo. That's it. I just also want to mention something about the drummer, besides the fact that he's a machine and so consistent in his timing. What's really important is when you have a simple song like this, I have no doubts, because I've seen it a bit from Devin himself, but I have no doubts that this band are all incredible musicians, capable of virtually anything they wanted, but they're just letting the song do its work, right? And they're letting the song be what it should be, which is a fantastic melody, almost dreamlike, very dreamy. And that beat, because there's such a big gap between his snare accents, what he does with his feet is important, really important. So that doof, 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 ka, that is like perfectly fitted to the song. Now, it's not a new beat. It's been done hundreds, if not thousands of times, but it is perfectly suited to this. And he's playing it really well. The consistency of each kick hit, really good. Fills. There you go. There's another example of just a subtlety, that little quick accent that almost came in just before the beat. So they hit it in just before, let it drag out. So it didn't change any time signature or anything like that, but it was just something to keep it fresh, keep it smart. It's musically very, very smart. Going back for that, I was actually just thinking about this the other day. When you scream, there are very few singers who are able to take a scream and make it change pitch, make it change like shift in a pitch. And I think he just did that right there. So that pitch, we kind of wound it up and he went into like a slightly higher register, if you will, with the scream. Very, very, very cool. Very, very awesome. I'm loving the song entirely, if you haven't noticed. It's so melodic and so dreamy, but so heavy and not heavy. And it's like a lot of things all in one. And it's just smart idea. It's like that, you know, it's when you're sitting warming up and you come up with a riff, and it's just something you could play. You could put on a loop and play and play and play. And they've turned that into a song, and a very smart one at that. I want to hear that scream again. Go back one more just so we can catch all of it. His voice, though, if he's got a lot of other songs like this in the set, his voice must go through absolute hell. There's ways of screaming that you don't damage your chords, and he's obviously knows what he's doing, but it still seems very, very, like, very intense on his vocal cords. So, yeah, I'm impressed. A lot of emotion too. Straight back into the clean. Such a difficult song to explain, because the beauty is in its simplicity. He's got outstanding vocals. They are very smart musicians. They don't miss a note. And I actually really, really like that one. I think Kingdom was more, and I didn't hear Kingdom with the full band. I just heard it in studio with like kind of a backing track and a lot of effects and stuff on. But that seemed like a showcase. It seemed more like a very good intro song for sure, because you get the personality, the skill, you get the talent. But this seemed like a song, something that sits in the middle of an album and is just a beautiful, almost interlude. And it's super smart. Really loved that. I definitely need to hear more. I hope you enjoyed that one, because I can tell you I really did. And sorry it took so long to get back to another Devin Townsend one, but there's lots of stuff on the list and I am working my way through it. I promise you, until the next one, please be safe, be nice to each other, and have a damn good day.